The following is a presentation of the Sunday Cup Radio Network.
Alright, welcome everybody to the awards banquet edition of Inside Sunday Cup Racing. We're here to celebrate and honor the champions and rookie of the year recipients of the 2003 season 3 season for the Sunday Cup League on Gran Turismo 5. We've had an outstanding season last season, a lot of good races, and we could have done any of it without you racers and the race fans watching us on YouTube and coming to the races. It's been awesome. We've had a good crop of rookies this year. I think we're going to take a few minutes to look back and see who was crowned Rookie of the Year in their respective division. And we've had a lot of good rookies this season for sure. And we're going to celebrate and honor a couple of them in each division. We'll start off with the Budweiser Bombers. We'll have Andy come to the stage and do a little presentation about the Bomber Series.
The Budweiser Bomber Series are a driver favorite Sunday Cup League. This class is stock Buick GNXs and stock Hyruxes depending on the track. The low horsepower really made for some close, beaten and banging short track racing in 2013. The newcomers did well in this class, and you know they learned the style involved with the Bombers. This provided all of our fans with a very intense Rookie of the Year battle. The best of all was the man from Sonora, California, Ice Chest 3. He slung his green IROC Z and GNX around the corners better than any other rookies, with one top 3 and 3 top 5s. The hard work paid off as Ice Chest claims the Budweiser Bomber Rookie of the Year award.
Yes, he did. And I think we have a little speech prepared here about the Bomber Series and Ice Chest. He did an awesome job. We're going to hear from him in a little bit here, but I want to say heartfelt congratulations to Ice Chest on a great season and some good racing on his behalf. You're the top rookie out of your class this season, Ice Chest, and we're proud to call you Sunday Cup League's 2013 Bomber Rookie of the Year. We're looking forward to see you in future races. You've definitely made it interesting every time you hit the track. And I understand you have prepared a little speech for tonight's event, so with no further ado, we'll ask Ice Chest to come up to the stage and tell us what he has to say.
Thank you, Johnny Benson. That was an amazing speech that you prepared for us. Well, the first thing I have to say is thank you, Johnny, Awoki, and whoever else that has helped prepare the races every weekend, you know, so everybody can come and race and have some fun. Honestly, I was really surprised when Johnny told me that I was the Sunday Cup League Bomber Rookie of the Year. And it's been a really amazing year. And hope to have GT6 now soon so I can come race with you all again. And I'll hand the mic out to somebody else. Thanks.
All right, Ice Jeff. Congratulations on being the best rookie in that class for the season. But there's always a championship, and one man dominated the entire Bomber season. If you'd like to walk to the stage and have a little thank you to everybody, we'll let Awaki 96 come up here, the 2013 Bombers champion.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you, Johnny. It's been a really good season, I think. We've been running GM cars from the 80s, and you know they're really good cars. I'd really like to thank GM for providing us with, you know, a nice racing vehicle, and I'd also like to thank everyone who showed up to race with us. It's been fun every weekend, racing with everybody and just watching everybody and then racing with everybody. It's such a big honor to me. So I'd like to thank everyone for that.
Alrighty, Andy, you did awesome this season. There was, you get out front and there was not much we could do to catch you. Plus, everybody was beating and banging in the back of the pack in those bombers cars, so that was never really conducive to catching the leader once you start beating and banging back there like that. So that was an awesome season. We hope to see the bomber sometime in the future. Right now, we don't have him on the schedule, so. It was an awesome class that we had, and we had some really good racing. I think everybody loved racing in that class, especially, of course, Ice Chest and Ahwaukee 96. But it's come to an end. Another class that has not come to an end and is going to live forward in the GT6 and is coming to a new prominent home on Thursday night is the late model sportsman division. Let's have our buddy Andy Oki have a little conversation with us, tell us what happened and what is going on with the late model championship.
Well, the late models, back the cars themselves, they're really easy cars to drive. A lot of people have praised them for their good handling and really kind of beginner-friendly handling. And so that allows everyone to be really aggressive, and that's exactly what happened this season. We've had a lot of knockdown, drawn-out battles in the late model sportsman class, and it didn't look like anyone could dethrone a Ahwaukee 96 in victory lane. Laser Cat actually had two wins, but the surprise Rookie of the Year winner was Coop 2903. Coop's one of the oldest rookies this season, but he really showed the young guns how to race for points. And he didn't win, but he did get two top threes and five top fives and seven starts. Coop did an awesome job. And we're proud to call you 2013 Season 3 Late Model Rookie of the Year. Coop couldn't make it tonight, but he did send his regards and best wishes to all the competitors that think they can beat him in 2014.
That's right. Burlington, Wisconsin's own Coop pulled it off this season. And personal message here to Coop. You did an awesome job in your first season here with us, Coop. Depending on the blood alcohol content of the driver in the number 14 car, we had two different Coops out there on the track. But you know how it is. They both gained enough points to call themselves late model sportsman rookie of the year. He was winless, but he showed them young guns really how to race for points. You ain't got to go out there and win every race. You just got to be there. And so he pulled off the late model sportsman, and speaking about running for points, he did an awesome job, and he is the overall Sunday Cup League Rookie of the Year. So you did an awesome job, Coop. You came out there. You didn't have the fastest car. You weren't the best driver on the track, but you pulled it off, and we're really proud of you. You did an awesome job, and we hope to see both you and your son out there, sorry, racing in the upcoming events on GT6. In the upcoming season, they can start to unveil that Cooper family legacy they've been talking so much about. So that's going to be awesome. He won the Rookie of the Year battle for the Late Model Sportsman. Right now, we're going to have the Late Model Sportsman Championship winner come up to the stage here, and I believe Ahwaukee 96 has a few people to thank.
Yeah. It's been, feels like I've come a long way since I joined Sunday Cup League. I remember back in 2012, I barely could hold a straight line, and I caused a few accidents, and people got mad at me, and I really like to thank JB Stig 76 and Tony Moose 68. Without those two guys, just kind of, well, they demolished me in my first few seasons. Without them, I wouldn't have had the feeling to need to get better and improve myself. And thanks to them, it just, they set the bar pretty high. And that just made me want to get up to that, the same level as they were. And, yeah, I'd really like to thank them for racing with me and never going easy on me.
Well, yeah, they never went easy on you, and you paid back the favor by never going easy on anybody else this season. You tore it up, and we're really proud of you. I mean, you're pretty much flawless out there, Milwaukee, so I mean, there's not much we can say. We'll see if you can back it up with another championship in the GT6. Nobody's got two in a row before. We'll see if you can do it. Alrighty, that's awesome. That was the late model sportsman and the bombers out of the way, but now we're going to turn our focus to the big daddy class, the awesome Grand National Division. These are the 2011 NASCARs, full horsepower. We tore it up on the track, short tracks and super speedways. We went everywhere. They were awesome. We're going to have Andy come to the stage and tell us a little rundown of what actually happened this season in the Grand National Division.
Well, like Johnny said, the Grand National Division is the big dog class in the Sunday Cup League. Some people might say that 892 horsepower is too much for the little short tracks. Others might say, bring it on. No one could take the points lead away from Milwaukee 96, and only two drivers were able to score wins, both on the weeks that Milwaukee did not race. The only rookie to pick up a victory in the Grand National Division was a cool cat from Canada, Laser Cats. Laser did a lot this season, including three top threes and five top fives. But even that doesn't give justice to Laser's driving style. The cat's fast and he can haul ass. Can't wait to see if Laser can challenge Milwaukee 96 for the Winston Cup Series Championship next season on GT6. It's going to be fun to see what you can do in the future there, Laser Cat. We'd like to hear from Laser on how he did it, but he's not here today. So he wants to thank everyone this season who had the chance to race him.
Yep, Laser did an awesome job, and we definitely want to say a big congrats to Laser Cats. He really showed us how to do it out there on the short tracks. That cat from Canada can really drive. Yeah, congrats. Awesome rookie season in the Sunday Cup League, Laser. You really put on a show out there, and we know at every event that Laser shows up, he's really going to put on a show for the audience. So it was awesome being a competitor, driving against you, watching you handle those cars like that. It was nuts. You really, you're the only Canadian in the series, and you really put it on all the other American rookies. So I think in the seasons to come, you could be the brightest star in the Sunday Cup League, Laser. You've shown some potential, and your improvement is outstanding. So it's going to be good to see you get out there on GT6 and do some more dirt tracking on the pavement. I know you guys drive on a lot of ice up there in Canada, and it shows off. You can really handle a loose car going into the corners, coming out. It doesn't matter. You go where they are not, and you remind me a little bit of JB Stick 76, former champion in the Sunday Cup League. He always figured out, you know, a different place on the track to race. And most people wouldn't even think about going up on the outside trying to get around people, but you really pulled it off. So it was real fun to see you out there, Laser. You got a couple victories this season, so that's really good for a rookie. Really good for a rookie. So we're proud to call you Grand National Division 2013 Rookie of the Year, Laser Cats. All right. And we talked about the rookie. Let's talk about the champion. We'll bring up to the stage a man that needs no introduction, partly because he's been on the stage all night, Milwaukee 96. Come on up. Tell us what happened there, Milwaukee. You did an awesome job winning that championship in the Grand Nationals.
Yeah, it's been, this is like my maybe fifth season in the Sunday Cup League, I think. And I think that's a lot of time to spend on, you know, figuring out how a car handles and how it drives and just trying to perfect the whole style of racing it involves. And I think experience had a lot to do with this one. I'd also like to thank the creators of the Gran Turismo series itself. I'd like to thank Sony for, you know, funding it, Polyphony Digital, Mr. Kazunori Yamauchi. I mean, without those guys, this literally wouldn't have been possible. You know, they provided us with the game. They provided us with realistic physics and cars so we can actually race each other with our own skill. And more importantly, I'd like to thank Johnny Benson for the player for creating Sunday Cup League. And bigger to me was allowing me to play a bigger part in the league, to help organize some of the events and, you know, do more important jobs than just being a driver in the league. And so, thank you, Johnny, for doing everything you've done for us.
It's been a pleasure, Iwaki. You've really come through both on the technical aspects of the lead, keeping track of everybody's points and everything, running the website. I mean, you do a lot for the league, and we're really proud to call you our champion this season. All right. That's awesome festivities for tonight. It's been a good show, everybody. I'd like to remind everybody, if they would like to join the league, you can always send SundayCup_League a PSN friend request. And we'll let you know of the upcoming events. You can always check out www.sundaycupleague.wix.com/SCRN for all the updates and the different goings-on of the sport. And every week we do this 30-minute weekly wrap-up show, Inside Sunday Cup Racing. You can look that up on Facebook. If you have any questions you need answered, you can tweet us at Sunday Cup League. We're available. We're out there, and we're racing every week. So if you guys want to come out there and show what you got, come on out. Any final words, Walkie?
Yeah, I'd like to say that I think 2013 has seen a lot of improvement in the Sunday Cup League. We've gained a lot of members, and we've gained a lot in how we run things, and I'd like to say all we can go is from here is up. I mean, yep. 2014, I think we'll see a completely new Sunday Cup League, one that's a lot better than what we have right now.
Yeah, the new game's going to bring a lot of different things into it. You know, different tracks, different cars. So it's definitely going to get better. We're just, me and Iwaki, we really try to strive to improve the competition any way possible. You know, definitely making tuning prohibited and the different lengths of the races and qualifying and everything. So we just try and make it as even and as fair as anybody can have. You know, it is racing, but we're trying to keep it pretty fair for you guys so you know that you can really show what you got. You don't have to worry about anything happening out there. You know, there's certain technical aspects we can't control, but everything else we try to govern it the best we can. So, all right, we're wrapped up this 2013 season. We'll see you guys at Daytona in February. We got the 13th through the 16th at Daytona. It's going to be the first points paying races for all the series. And then the Sunday before that, we got the Busch Clash. Yeah, that's a fun little race down there at Daytona. So we hope to see you all on GT6 and come on out and race with us. We'll have a good time. But for everybody here at the Sunday Cup League and inside Sunday Cup Racing, we'd like to bid you adieu tonight. So thanks, everybody, for coming out and racing, joining us in the show, and we'll see you next time.